Ooh. It's sleek. It's sexy. I've never had an iPhone, so as far as I'm concerned, that looks like an iPhone. Hello? No, I'm in the middle of a video right now. No, that, let me call you back when I'm done. All right, see? Works just like an iPhone. And it charges batteries. So that's handy. It's almost like we're in bed together. So we got ourselves something to look at today. And I think you might like it. You know, as far as these kind of things go. I'll have to go off camera to open this because, oh wait, Hulk out. After all the damage that we had, I had to replace my battery chargers. So I went looking around and I saw this touchscreen. Well, you know, I am a cell phone kind of guy. I like to poke things. Probably just like you. This is the HTRC, right? Yes, see, didn't even need glass for that. HTRC 100 AC-DC, goes both ways, charger. In this kind of day and age, you want to be able to go both ways, right? Cut, next scene. So let's open up the box, take a look at this lovely charger. Boom, yes. Foam. I like when they pack things nice though. You have to agree that that's nice. Here it is. Take it out of the foamy bag they got. Someday I'm gonna make that a hoodie. And there you go. Nice and small, very powerful, and has a label on it. Warning, Dr. Smith, Will Robinson, danger. Haha, what was that from? But half of you can't even guess that. So other things in the box, there is a power cord for plugging into the wall, which is AC last I checked. However, don't quote me, times are changing. You never know what it'll be next time. We've got a power connection if you connect it to a DC source, not the comics, like a battery, car battery, or something like that. There is a connection, it is an XC60 to a Deans, and you can connect it to this Deans, and this goes into your power supply on this side, much like this is. You can see the Dean connector there and the XT60 here. You get a balance board. So, not real big fan of that balance board. You'll see why in a second. Now, the one problem with this is that you can only charge one battery with the balance board at a time, unless, of course, you had a pigtail. You could probably do it. So I thought, well, you know, why do I want to do that? You know, this thing is pretty strong and it can handle a lot of stuff, so I went out and got that. And all the links will be down below. You just follow that Mad Monkey Dad down there and you'll be able to click on that and see what that is. But what this is, I just so happen to have an open one. This is like a cooking show, right? They go, oh, here's the ingredients, and all of a sudden the food pops up. Hook it up like that. Here's the power in, there are the connectors to the charger. And then you can connect up to 5 batteries of the same voltage. Don't go putting 4S and 3S and 6S on there. It's either all 6S, all 5S, or all 3S. Okay, I don't want you blowing up half the world, you know, because you wanted to mix your batteries. This is very well put together. I'm happy that I got it. One of the reasons I got it is because it has these little circuit breakers on the board. I don't know if you can see those down here. They're next to the buttons right here. And right here, hopefully you'll see that. I'll just put a picture up if later on I find out you can't see it, but you can see them all off to the side here. Originally when I bought this, it said it was 25 amp breaker, circuit breaker, but this one, these say 40 on it. So, you know, maybe they upped their game or something before I got it. Lucky me. This is about a 3-inch screen and you can see all the icons on it. We'll explain those in a second, but it looks pretty nice, doesn't it? So you can like wow your friends when you come to the race and you go, oh, let me put my charger down. Look at that screen, huh? I don't know. Wait, you got one too? Crap. I already used this And some of the things that are fun, I'll show you the video where we're doing it, are these buttons. So first off, let's just show you what you can do to it. You've got a selection of batteries on the second row going down to the third row, right? Oh yeah, second and third row are all sorts of batteries. One of the batteries, I was surprised, includes a smart battery charger. So if you have a DJI or DJI products, or maybe you still have a 3DR Solo, or you have that other one that nobody talks about, that's Europe likes it a lot, but you know, none of us buy it. So it's some aircraft that, you know, on the screen here, several buttons. I don't know if you can see that. If I hold it up this way, maybe it'll tune in, turn on. There we go. So now you can see all the buttons up there. There's a settings button here. There's a memory button here, which is kind of useless. I'll explain that in a second. There's a monitor, so you can look at stuff, monitoring stuff, like a hall monitor, you know? And then that one is a calibration, which maybe someday you'll have to do that, but at this point in time, when you get these direct from the factory, they are usually generally pretty well calibrated. I'm not sure why they put this memory one in here, but we'll click it. And I'll bring it up to the screen. And this allows you to store up to 6 types of batteries to charge. Now the only thing that was tricky on this was if you do choose to store things in memory, I found that when you get these and you want to edit them, let's grab one real quick. Let's do that one. So you can select one. So you can select one, it's now yellow. You hit the middle thing for edit. Oh, wait a minute. Edit. But when I was doing the change in this and I wanted to save it, I would hit save and thought, okay, that was good. No, you have to actually pick one of these and hit save, and then it changes it. You can see it now says 3.7 volts instead of the 3.7 amps versus the 5.0 amps that was on before. This unit is auto sensing. Let's get back to the main screen because it's prettier. This is auto sensing. So if you plug a battery into it, it tells you what it is. And then when you go to charge it, I can't do it now because not one's on there, but I did have some video before. You go in, you pick your battery, and then you'll be able to make a selection there of how you want to charge or discharge your battery or store it, put it in storage. And I really like this little interface it has. So if you hit balance, because balance is probably one of the better ways to treat your batteries. You can see you'll be able to adjust parameters, and for some reason or another, if you wanted to save it, you'd save it. Like you'll see here, there's a graph that goes on while it's charging, and it shows it what you're doing. While you're charging, it also monitors the cell voltage in each cell, and I like the display on that, so I thought, oh, you know what? That's for me, because I'm a techie kind of guy. This charger runs for about $59.99 on Amazon. I'm sure you can probably find it cheaper somewhere else, but I'll leave you Amazon links. This was about $10. I liked it, obviously, a lot better than this one because it's just a little bit more versatile. If you see what I'm getting at, it's versatile. Haha, what? I didn't make it. I ran this and some people complained it got hot. This one did not get hot. It's got a very nice fan right here. One of the things I really liked about this was as it was charging, you can see here, as it gets to its charge, it really tries to balance everything out really well. And matter of fact, as it shut down, the fan went off and I thought, oh, you're done, but it wasn't. It was kind of swapping volts between batteries, and it finally brought everything up to 100 charge. Just to go over some of the aspects of the box, that's where the electrical plug plugs in. This would be your DC connection. There are two connections right here. One is to upgrade the firmware and one is to get a heat sensor if you need to have a heat sensor. You know, I use thermometers, they all work the same. So on the other side of the box, because there's really nothing over here or on the back, sorry, $60, what do you want? The connection for the balance lead, the connection for your plugs that you'll be using to either charge or whatever you're gonna do with it. So the HTRC charger, HT100 AC/DC, comes with a manual. However, the manual is about as brief as it gets. The English is really good in it though, but probably about as brief as it gets. Luckily, there's not a lot of explanation you have to do with these. It does give you some nice charts and looks at stuff, so, but it doesn't really go into detail like that. The programming memory, it doesn't really, it gives you step by step for things, but it doesn't tell you exactly all the steps. So, you know, they got you there, okay? They improved their English, but they were light on explanation. So, you know, you choose. From the beautiful city of Tampa, Florida, where I've just hung my TV. Look, it looks like a hospital room TV, right? What? That's a good job, man. I paid someone $100 to do that, because I wasn't gonna do it. Okay, where was I? From the beautiful city of Tampa, Florida, in some undisclosed location in my new secret lair that's a hologram out there. It's really actually down deep in the ground. This is the Mighty Thor. See ya!